These are the plugins that you can use to create a complete style guide for any Figma project that you're trying to do. Now, the first one is going to be Foundation. And to get Foundation plugin, you're going to go to this place, go to plugin and search for Foundation. So here is the Foundation color generator. You can use it to generate colors, but it's going to be different types of colors. You can even use it to generate color palettes for your design. So assuming you want to do select any colors, you can actually come here and pick any color you want, and it gives you different shades of those colors that you're picking. So if I push this to this point and move this thing up, it gives me a different shade of this. So let's just go and add blue. I'm going to use this blue, and once done, I'm just going to say create style. Now, if you want to create tokens, you can also create tokens. If you want to create palettes, you create palettes. If you want to create styles, you create styles. Then if you want to create a palette for this, you just click on palette and it will create it for you. Look at it here. So this is what it just created for me, and I can actually add this on my style guide. So now if I want to add this color set to create styles, I'll use it to create this style. Now it has created this style for me. You see all these styles here has been created, all these color styles has been created for you, and you just use it and add to your design. So assuming I want to change the background of this thing, this design, that I come to this place, I can just choose this, because this is a variable, that's why you're seeing white as black, right? So now if I come here and scroll down, this is where you will see the color here. You see Foundation, you now see all the colors that has been generated for you. You can just click on it. Now you have changed the background color on this place. So go to the next plugin that would blow your mind away, and this plugin is Fig. You just search for Identity by FigR. Look at it here, generate design system with AI. Right, so this is the one I'm looking for. So I'm just going to click on it and just going to say which interactive guide is the plugin. I'm just going to click on use plugin. So once you just click on that, it automatically generates a color system for you. So if you want to change, these are the primary colors and these are the secondary colors. It doesn't generate these colors as styles, color styles. It generates it as variables. So it will go and create a whole full stack of color variables for you. So it's now easier for you to set up your color variables. So I'm just going to come here and change this color. So if I want to change this to something that looks like blue, and yeah, we're going to use this blue, and you see the color is changing here also. So save changes, and I'm going to come here again and do the same thing. I'm going to save, then come here and give my 200 is going to be darker, and this one is going to be 400. My 400 is going to be, I'm just kind of showing you what this looks like, but this is not what I'm going to use. Then we use a darker shade of it. So I'm just going to pull this out so you see the effect of what I'm doing. So now we assume that these are the colors, that these are going to be primary colors. If you want to add, you can just come here and add more shade. Just close this, and if you want to rename this, you just come here and rename this. You can just call it blue 100. This is very, very important, because that is how the Figma variables is going to pick it up. So from here, I'm just going to rename this one to blue 200. Come here, rename this to blue 300. Then on this part, I'm just going to do the same thing. I'm going to say blue 400. So for this, I might just decide to now do one thing, delete it. So once that is off, we don't have 500 anymore. So this will cease to exist. So we just have this 100, 200. So we can just call this main blue in brackets. So just to set things right. So here it has already renamed it for you. And you see that that 500 is no longer existing. That's one amazing thing about this plugin. Super cool, right? So we'll leave this as our secondary, we'll leave this as our neutral, but for this neutral, we're definitely going to make sure that this is pure white. Make sure that this is the code, so you just save it. So we just call this white, we just rename this white, and we are going to go to the black section and name this black. We're not going to name it 1000, so we just call it black. Mind you, you can also change the colors and we just get it darker. So this is black. So if you come here, you'll see it here. This is white and this is black. So we can actually change all of this to anything, maybe gray 100, gray 200, gray 300. This is our red, could be an error, this is a warning, this is a success message, and that's just it. So once I'm done, I'll just click on create color variables, but I'm not done yet. This is for typography. So now it has generated typography for me, and these are the fonts that you would be using. If you want to change all of this, you can say create typography in styles, create typography styles in Figma. So once I just click on this, it will create it. If you want to change it, you can actually change this whole stuff. This is by default Inter, and you can also change the font sizes. You also have your spacing. This is the spacing you're going to be using, and it can also add up as your variables. Now if we go to colors, let me show you guys something. Then I'm trying to not make this video necessarily long, so I'm just going to click on create colors. Now it's just creating design tokens. I'm just going to wait for it to finish exporting our token, and yeah, tokens created in Figma. Now we're done with this whole thing. Remember to name your project, right? So once you're done, you just close this, and we're going to bring 16 Pro and we'll lighten this up. Just lighten the space up. So to change the color of this, I'm just going to simply come here and pick the style. You see the white, right? So now to see all those things that was generated, go to local variables, come here and look for global tokens, because we didn't name this thing, we just look for it. So here you see the blue main that we did. So from here you can actually rename it blue tokens. I think I skipped that. You just have to name your project first. So for you to rename it from here, you just call this any project that you want. You could just call it anything, just call it LogRocket. Then that's it, and you will see all those colors that was generated for us, all of them. I'm just going to stop here. Don't forget to subscribe to LogRocket for amazing content like this. I'm going to see you guys on the next video.